So I'm hanging out here at our CBC Smithville campus for a very important reason. And a lot of you guys, if I had to guess, although you maybe haven't said it, have maybe wondered, why are we as a church bothering to put all this effort into construction and building and renovating this campus to start a new campus in Smithville? Why don't we just build onto our building in Bastrop and make it bigger so that we can have more people there? And the reason being that we as a church are trying to reach people where they are. And today, as we continue our series, Influencer, we're talking about what it means to influence the people around us in a way that's gonna influence them for good. Because there's a lot of animosity, there's a lot of hate, a lot of anger going on right now. And the world needs a good influence. And I think that we as Christians have that influence. So we're in the middle of this series and we're talking about how it is that we can influence people around us with the love of God. And oftentimes when we think of influencers, we think of people with millions of followers on Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, whatever, because they can reach a lot of people at once. But think about this. Have you ever thrown a pebble into the water? What happens? You get ripples, right? And no matter how big or how small the pebble is, the ripple always starts at the same place. It's where it meets the water. There may be many ripples being made, some of them bigger, some of them smaller, but regardless, the biggest impact is always at the point of contact where the rock hits the water. When we think about influencers, we think about famous people. They're like giant boulders being thrown into the pool. They make a big splash, the ripples reach a little bit further. But today, we're gonna talk about influencing in a big way by living a small life. In Matthew chapter 5, we look at Jesus's Sermon on the Mount, and we're gonna read just a small chunk of scripture from that you have no doubt heard, but read with me in Matthew chapter 5, starting in verse 14, we read this: "You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden, nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven." I remember I used to be in a band and we were touring from one city to the next, and it was about 1 o'clock in the morning. We finished a show and we're driving to the next city and we are just starving to death after playing this hour-long show. And we're out in the middle of nowhere. There's just no cars on the road. It is pitch black as we're just driving down the street. And we are starving and suffering, and lo and behold, we see off in the distance the beautiful golden arches of McDonald's. And it's kind of like that. If you've ever been driving at night and you see those beautiful golden arches, it's impossible to miss the light when there's darkness all around. The point being this, that you can't miss the influence of someone whose life reflects the light of Jesus. We all have the ability to be a light in the darkness. That's what influencers do. Now read with me in Hebrews chapter 10. "And let us consider how to stir up one another to love and good works, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near." As followers of Jesus, we want to share his message with as many people as possible. We want to make the world a better place. We want to be an example of goodness and hope and use our influence to fight for others who are in need. And so the question is this: if we have these big things to do, these huge world-changing things to do, why does the Bible make reference to so many small details about how to get along with the people that are closest to us? It's because this: if we want to influence the world around us, we need to help others keep on shining. And to do that, we have to harness the power of proximity. That the people closest around us need us and we need them. That we, if you remember from last week, have wisdom to share with the closest ripple of our community, and that they have wisdom to share with us, and that we have the best chance at being our best selves when we intentionally influence with the people closest to us. I don't know if you know about the creation of Velcro, but it's something like this. In the early 1900s, a Swiss inventor named George de Mestral took his dog out for a walk. And when he got home, George noticed that he and his dog were just covered in little burrs. And he was fascinated by these small little pokey plants. And what George did was he immediately began inspecting the burrs under his microscope, and he found that the seed pods were covered in tiny hooks which allowed them to grab onto the soft loops in the fabric of his pants and on his dog's fur. And so George decided to create a two-sided fastener, one with small hooks and the other with small loops, and now we know it as Velcro. Now his invention has been used all over the world for thousands, if not millions of jobs. And it's even used in outer space. Apparently, some astronauts attach patches of Velcro to the inside of their helmets in order to scratch their nose. George probably never dreamed that he would one day serve and influence astronauts, right? But because he paid attention to the small things, he was able to make a big difference. So to make a big impact, you have to be willing to live small. That means living as though even your smallest actions at home, at school, with those closest to you in your ripple, that those actions matter the most. Yeah, you may have opportunities to impact millions with something you say, how you act, with who you are, but we rarely see those moments coming. And in one moment, your ripple could reach an entire nation, but it starts at the point of impact. It's happened for many leaders, for teachers, activists, influencers throughout history. It could happen to you too, but the world is a big place. You have the ability to impact it in big ways, but some influencers get so caught up on influencing the people in their outermost ripples that they miss the influence they already have to the people who are closest to them. When we treat every person, every opportunity, and every potential chance to influence someone like it really, truly matters, because it does, that's when we become influencers that we were created to be. To be an influencer, you have to live small and dream big. And that's why we are here in Smithville, because we want to reach people where they are. So reach people where you are. Live small and dream big. We'll see you next week.